Stormy and Max. Now here's another sweet-looking couple. If you've been listening to these stories, you already know about Max. As you can see, the devil lurks just beneath the surface.
Max was a prankster.
But I will say this. Of all the original Zebra couples, Stormy and Max have stayed together over all these years. Before ZBS was formed, Max and Miles owned a women's clothing store in Philadelphia, Paraphernalia. They thought it would be a good way to meet women, but it turned out the women they met were only interested in the clothes. They did have a store manager, Shelley, so finally they said to her, "Take care of things. We're taking a long vacation." Their friend, Dave Adams, Mojo, drew a comic strip for a weekly newspaper in Philly. He used the name P.Q. Quattlebaum. The Vietnam War was going on. Nixon was president. So Dave drew a cartoon of Richard Nixon. He's bent over, his pants pulled down, while his right hand holds up a V sign, an ABM missile is being shot out of his bare butt. Max had made it into a poster, and he sold it to raise funds for the Chicago 7. While Max and Meatball were touring New Mexico in their converted school bus, Miles put the Nixon poster in the front window of Paraphernalia. Anyone walking along the street couldn't miss it. Their store was on Chestnut Street, in the fashionable section of Philadelphia. Bonwit Teller, the luxury department store, was right across the street. One afternoon, Frank Rizzo, the chief of police, later the mayor of Philadelphia, was driving down Chestnut Street when he saw the Nixon poster in their window and went bananas.
Luckily, it was Sunday. The store was closed.
When Max and Miles were on the road, they'd find a payphone and check in with Shelley.
This predates cell phones.
And when Max called, she was desperate. Rizzo said, "Take it down." Max said, "No, it stays." When the cops came back, Shelley explained, "The owners insist the poster remain in the window." They arrested Shelley.
She spent the night in jail.
Even though Max did fly back and did bail her out, she never forgave him, or Miles, who was off hitchhiking, God knows where.
Okay, one more.
Whenever Meatball was in Los Angeles, he'd stay with Don Van Vliet,
Captain Beefheart and his magic band.
The band lived there too. It was in an older part of Woodland Hills up near Topanga. Once, while Meatball was there, Max and Miles came by. They were always goofing around, and one day Beefheart turned to Meatball and said,
"They never grew up, did they?"
Beefheart and the band had little money and little to eat, so Max said, "Let's go shopping. Come on, my treat." Max, Miles, Meatball, and two of the band members, Rockette Morton and I think it was Zoot Horn Rollo, piled into their converted school bus, and they drove to a Safeway supermarket in Woodland Hills that was California gigantic. Max said, "I'll give you 5 minutes to fill your carts and get back to the checkout." Luckily, there weren't many shoppers, so there were no accidents. They ran up and down the aisles, tossing in hams, steaks, roasts, chops, bacon, eggs, bread, piles of frozen veggies, cheeses, pizzas, beer, milk, bananas, while Max called out the minutes.
4, 3, 2, 1.
They made it back, though Rockette Morton nearly tipped over his heaping cart while careening around a corner trying to get to the checkout. As he was paying, Max saw an LP by Frank Sinatra. He put the record in Rockette's cart. He thought it'd be funny to watch Beefheart's face when he found it. If you've never heard Captain Beefheart and his magic band, give a listen.
Tropical hot dog night. Like two flamingos in a fruit fight.
You may notice it's not at all like Sinatra. While they were unloading the groceries, Beefheart picked up the LP and asked, "What's this?" Max, with a sly, devilish grin, said, "It's for you." Beefheart held the album at arm's length. He was silent for a moment, and then he said, "I've always admired Frank. I wish I could hold a note the way he can."